Hey everybody, this is John the Other, obviously, and I'm going to read something today relating to an article published in the Globe and Mail by David Butt, the lawyer. David Butt is a Toronto-based criminal lawyer who routinely acts for complainants in sexual assault cases. That's his introduction at the head of his June 11 article published in the online edition of the Globe and Mail. But Mr. Butt is a bit more than just a Toronto criminal lawyer. He's a bit of a minor celebrity in Canada and something of a rock star in the social justice legal activism community. David Butt was the lawyer retained by one of the accomplices of false accuser Lucy Ducouture. He was desperate to get in on that spectacular false accusation hoax, but the best he could do was Sarah Dunsworth. Her role in Lucy Ducouture's public self-humiliation was to have been to corroborate Ducouture's story, but she was shown in court to have been coached by Ducouture and was then still unable to remember her lines. Mr. Butt also made a name for himself as the lawyer hired by the professional sex assault extortionist and scam artist Mandy Gray. She's the pizza-faced hustler who forced herself sexually onto a student in York University's political science PhD program, then accused him of sexual assault, terminating his academic career and sending him temporarily to jail, before the verdict of the incontinent and insane Ontario Court Judge Martin Zucker was overturned by the sane adult in the room lawyer Mark Halfyard. David Butt also attempted to add Mandy Gray's court costs to the sentence handed out by Zucker to that York University student, which is to say, Mr. Butt attempted to have his own legal fees added to a wrongly convicted man's sentence. Now, it's important to note that paying for the other side's legal costs when you lose your case is not something that happens in criminal court. That's something that happens in civil court. Which brings us back to that opening sentence of Mr. Butt's Globe and Mail article. Quote, David Butt is a Toronto-based criminal lawyer who routinely acts for complainants in sexual assault cases. Now, complainants in Canadian criminal trials do not need lawyers, because their complaints are represented by the Crown Prosecutor. It is the accused in Canada's criminal courts who need to hire lawyers. The complainants do not need lawyers because the grievance of a complainant is argued by a prosecutor appointed by the Crown. David Butt, by the way, is not a Crown Prosecutor. So what is Butt doing representing complainants in sex assault cases? Stated simply, he is undermining the integrity of the court. A citizen accused of an indictable offense in Canada risks the loss of everything they have worked for their entire life, including their freedom. And such an accused person must, with only their own resources, defend themselves against an opponent with all the power, the knowledge, and the financial reach and the enforcement authority of the state. This is one of the most important reasons that the Crown Prosecution must disclose in advance to an accused person what evidence will be brought against them in court, and why an accused person does not need to reveal in advance what evidence they may bring in their own defense. The prosecutor, by the way, has the duty to seek the truth. That is the reason why the prosecutor does not work directly for the complainant. It is also not the complainant who will put the accused in a locked cell in the basement of, say, the complainant's house. It is the state who will do this, with all its reach, financial power, and enforcement capabilities. And an accused person must win in the court against this most capable and powerful opponent. That's why a complainant does not need a lawyer. So Mr. Butt is perverting the function of the court. That's his introduction to his article. But let's move past the introduction and see what else he says. Change is in the air, he says, before explaining that, quote, sexual assault survivors have for months been vocal about their dissatisfaction with the criminal justice system. And that is a very strange thing for a lawyer to say. David Butt is not talking about people found in the court to have been victimized by sexual assault. Nor is he talking about people known by the public to have been victims, who maybe due to legal technicality did not win their complaints. Mr. Butt mostly isn't even talking about complainants in sexual assault cases. He's talking about activists and academics, who mostly do not even have specific claims of having been sexually assaulted. The word survivor is inappropriate, especially from an officer of the court. And of those few, quote, survivors having a claim on the title complainant, we are looking at actors whose stories collapsed under the weight of their own internal inconsistencies and contradictions. A more truthful man might say accusers, but Mr. Butt is a criminal lawyer, and as such, he is an expert in the use of language. You might even say that choosing the right words to convince listeners of a point of view is his profession. But nowhere in his article does this lawyer ever use the word complainant. Instead, this lawyer only says survivors. Now, Mr. Butt is a member of the bar, and he is an officer of the court, and he is showing us his contempt for the presumed innocence of an accused person until proven guilty beyond a reasonable doubt. The voices of these activists and academics, who Mr. Butt insists on calling victims, have, he says, given fresh vigor to the cliche, we are mad as hell and we're not going to take it anymore. And this is a cliche, although not an appropriate one. It was uttered by the actor Peter Finch, portraying a news anchorman having an on-air meltdown after prolonged mistreatment by his corporate bosses. In the current innovations to our courts, the establishment are the feminists, and the activists, and the academics, the people that lawyer David Butt calls survivors. Well, they'd be the ones abusing Peter Finch to the point of a mental breakdown. The abused underdog, played by Peter Finch, he would be the guy dragged through an increasingly Kafkaesque court system on phony charges where the inquisitors call themselves victims, or who David Butt calls survivors.
You keep using the word. I do not think it means what you think it means.
Mr. Butt also writes that earlier this week, the current Liberal government introduced proposed legislation that, in Mr. Butt's words, is giving sexual assault survivors increased rights of participation in court proceedings about the use of their private records and their prior sexual history. There's that funny word again, survivors. For clarity, what he means is activists and academics. But the legislation that Butt is talking about is Bill C-51. This is the bill that will prevent an innocent accused person from bringing evidence into the court which establishes their innocence. Text messages, voice recordings, or video recordings made either before or after a sexual encounter and directly addressing that sexual encounter, such as a comment like, "That was some high-quality humping you laid on me last night. Let's do it again." That would be barred from entry into evidence without first making an application to the court and getting approval from the complainant. No, you can't bring text messages which include consent to sex. No, you can't bring the text messages which included an appreciation for the sex that was had. And no, you can't bring text messages asking for more of the same. All of that would be barred from entry into evidence by this new law. David Butt describes these proposed changes to law with the language, quote, "These changes are commendable, but they are baby steps," end quote. He is talking about removing an accused person's right to bring specific evidence of their innocence to court, and he calls this commendable. Commendable is not the word that I would choose. An affront to the concept of civil rights and an outrage against civilization. That's what I would call it. A few paragraphs on in his article, Mr. Butt points out that in a nationally unified criminal code such as we have in Canada, a resident of one province doesn't need to worry about being prosecuted when in a different province for something assumed to be legal because it was legal back home. But what Mr. Butt seems unaware of is that a resident of any province can be prosecuted for something that was illegal, but was not engaged in. Nor does Mr. Butt seem to have any awareness that in Canada, an accused person has a right under Section 6 and 7 of the Canadian Charter to full answer in defense of an accusation. In fact, it is shocking to the conscience that an officer of the court would, writing in a public organ such as the Globe and Mail, describe as gross a violation of the civil rights of the accused proposed in Bill C-51 as commendable, and suggest further and more far-reaching violations would be called for by the use of the term baby steps. But David Budd is not unaware, because unlike the ill-educated activist sociopaths that he is pandering to, he is a highly skilled and experienced criminal lawyer and an officer of the court. So his repeated use of the word survivor in place of the more correct words like activist or complainant is purposeful. The use of activist jargon in Mr. Butt's article is to appeal to those activists who, with now so much political power, are reformatting our courts into their own ideal star chambers. And although David Butt is a learned man and a member of the bar, his article is not a learned exploration of proposed changes to law. He is merely advertising his services to ideologues now vandalizing and discarding your civil rights for their political gain. And he will not be disciplined by the Bar of Ontario or the Criminal Defense Bar, whose oaths he is sworn to uphold. They have no political will except to obediently appease. So despite that he is working as hard as a one-armed pimp at a bitch-slapping contest to degrade, devalue, and pervert the Canadian courts and undermine the integrity of the court in the eyes of the public, Mr. Butt will not be disbarred. But if for whatever reason you find yourself in need of a lawyer and David Butt's name is offered to you, this lawyer's continued insistence on using the word survivor, where he should properly be saying complainant, or more accurately, activist, this tells you one thing with absolute clarity. David Butt does not believe in the most basic and core principle that an accused person is assumed innocent until proven guilty. Thanks very much for listening, and as always, have a lovely day.